Hi, this is Tony DeFrank with California Car Cover and Covering Classic Cars. I'm here with Steve Rostam, one of our longtime customers and our participant in this year's annual Father's Day cover photo shoot. So him and his family participated, and Steve's been a longtime customer, and he owns this beautiful 59 Cadillac, amongst others. So this is a complete frame-off restoration, so you can tell us a little bit about the car and like what kind of condition you found it in.
Yeah, actually, it's a local car. We found it in Northridge, of all things, and it was all apart. But everything was there and it was labeled. The only problem was it was labeled in Hebrew, because the guy had a friend of his was helping him and he was Jewish speaking, so he just marked everything in Hebrew. So when I started putting it back together and I called him, I said, I need help. I don't know what anything says. He says, I don't speak Hebrew. So where's the guy who wrote it? He said, he's gone. I haven't seen him in years. So it was a stalled project that they worked on it in the 80s, and then he started on a new company, so the car just sat. So nothing ever got done to it, and then we bought it in 2006, and we finished it by 2009.
Okay, so paint, trim, interior, everything was...
Everything's been redone on it. Every nut and bolt was redone on it. And we drive it. It has about 2,800 miles on it since we finished it. We got married in it, so it kind of has sentimental value for us because we restored it together when we were dating. So I think it's one of the things that's going to be with us for a long time.
Definitely. I mean, that's what we thought. It was a great car. And Steve has a beautiful family, and we're glad they participated in our photo shoot this year. And so you would say, like, this is the favorite car in your collection?
Probably the 55 Buick, the convertible in the background. I've had that. I bought that in college in Santa Barbara, and I've had it for, it's the longest car I've ever owned. I've had it for about 22 years or so now.
Okay.
So I think that's the one, that's probably my favorite.
All right. And if you've been a longtime customer of our company, pre-kids, we did a photo shoot here with Steve. He brings some amazing cars to our events each year. And so we've shot his Buicks in the past. So if you have a collector catalogs over the years back, and we were talking today, back actually is 2013. So 7 years ago we shot here with Steve. But now with this growing family and seems like ever-growing car collection or project collection that he has, we thought it was a great time to come back again and participate in the shoot. Now, this is an award-winning car. I guess there's some, what other projects or what other award winners are you have in the garage that we'll check out in a little bit?
Yeah, and this car, the testament of the quality of the restoration, it was finished in 2009, and we shipped it to Las Vegas for the Cadillac Grand National Meet, and it was the 50th year of the 59, so there was about 15 of them there. And it was the only car that got the senior badge that year. And then we showed it at the local concourses and, you know, the Greystone Mansion and Palace Verdes and the L.A. Concours and different ones. And in 2019, which was 10 years after its restoration, it placed best in class at the Palace Verdes Concours again. So it's been held up really well, and it gets used and it gets maintained very well. And we do all that stuff here at the house here. So. And then the other cars are the two Buicks in the background are they've been restored as well. They've won like the LA Concours a couple times. I think I've shown them both at Palace Verdes, and they both have the Antiquado Wheel Club senior badges, and the same with the Cadillac. It has that senior badge for the AACA as well. So we try to participate in the different clubs and go to the different meets, and most of the meets are weekend-long meets, so the kids are starting to get to the point that they really enjoy it now. So
hopefully they're enjoying it. I thought you were going to tell me, like, and they're about done after like 3 hours, but
no,
as long as they're enjoying it.
So we stay in the resort, we go swimming, and we do different things with them, so they enjoy the cars, and we're trying to keep them interested, so hopefully
that's key. You got to start them young, so they want to keep going to the shows. I try to get the girls out to as many shows as I can, and I got a battle with art school and other events on the weekends, but I try to get them out to as many meets as we can. And Steve is real active in the local, the LA chapter of the Buick and GM Club. He hosts a big event each year in the Southern California. So that's always a great event that attracts, because we go to a lot of car shows around the country, and it's Chevys and Fords, and that's a bit. But you are involved with the Buicks, the Oldsmobiles, the Pontiacs, the Cadillacs.
Yeah, and we get a
little of everything.
Mix. It's a different mix. So the General Motors Show, it's the only one that's in this area that we have, and you get a lot of cars that a lot of people don't get to see. So it's really nice to get those cars out, and there's some really phenomenal cars that show up year to year. So it's an enjoyable meet, and it's smaller now. It's about 250 cars or so. At its height, it was about 475. I think it was the highest number of cars that we got. So, but it's fun to do it, and we still enjoy doing it. Our volunteers are getting smaller because they're getting tired of doing it. But
hey, I think every car club has the same problem. My classic Chevy club, we have the same issue. There's only so many people to go around and do everything, and everyone gets a little tired. But it's great to do a community event and promote the car culture to, like I said, our kids, and then like my parents are excited to get their grandkids involved in the in the car thing. So it's really cool. That's what keeps the industry going for all of us.
Exactly. Yeah, we got to keep them interested, and it's a good hobby to have, actually. You know, they get to build something. They look for stuff. It teaches them patience. It teaches them, you know, attention to detail, and it's really important, I think.
And what I guess there's a car. There's a beautiful Cadillac. You take it to a lot of events. So every time it goes out, does somebody ask you to buy it? How often?
Yeah, that happens a lot. One time I was getting gas with it recently, actually, and a guy asked me if I was the original owner.
What are you trying to say?
Yeah, and a person next to me is like, did he just ask you if you're the original owner? I said, yeah. And he says, how old does he think you are? I said, I don't know. But
hopefully he thought it was an 82. Yeah. No. But what about, I guess, because there's something just about the classic Cadillacs. I don't know if it's just the big fans, but like, late 50s, like early 60 Cadillacs, everyone just loves them.
And yeah,
we go to the,
a lot of attention.
We go to all Pomona swap meets, like, you know, almost monthly. Go to any of the shows, even with international like buyers from overseas, like they just love the big fins.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I think there's more 59 Cadillacs in Sweden than there are over here. And a couple of the other cars that we have are 58 Buicks, and they love those in Sweden as well. And actually, for reproduction parts, some of the dash pieces and things like that they're making, they're doing a better job over there than they are here. So for this last one, we got the pieces from them, and it just comes out phenomenal, and their attention to detail is incredible. But I don't know, it's something about the fins. I guess it's an excess. You know, they always had smaller little cars, and we have little cars, we have MGs, and you can't compare them. It's just it's a world of difference when you're sitting in this and if you're sitting in a little sports car. And it's just amazing what we built back then. I was cleaning the grill the other day thinking, look at how many different pieces are went to make this grill, and there's nothing like that now. All the cars are just one.
Now it'd be stamped, like no one's gonna be like, yeah, that's the grill we wanted to design in like 2020 for a vehicle. They want to make sure it's high shine but easy to pump out, and that's yeah it's pretty, it's interesting just the detail, like we're looking at the just the dash,
yeah,
the wrapped leather dash, all the gauges and how they're separate,
they're kind of in
pods and individual, like there's the one, I guess the one like Cadillac badge pod, then you have the clock, and everything is separate on the vehicle, and there's like no way that they that would kind of be approved right now to like to in a vehicle, the intricacy of the build.
Exactly, and you know, a lot of the rules and regulations are kind of what sets your designs now, so they kind of step away from the way that was done back in the past. And actually, when you're driving this car, it kind of feels like you're kind of in a cockpit a little bit because of the way the dash pod is, so it kind of brings you in, and the steering wheel's a little bit smaller than the previous years were. And it's very interesting to drive it. It doesn't feel like a big car when you're in it. When you come to park it, that's a different
thing. When you park, I said, yeah. But you might not think it's a big car, but everyone around you sees it's
like
a big
car. It's like an aircraft carrier. Put that over there.
Yeah. That's awesome. Well, great. Well, Steve, hey, thank you so much for taking some time with us. And we'll get some shots of some of the other cars around here in the garage. Again, check us. Want to see more information or more photos of the vehicle? Just check out our Facebook page and blog. But otherwise, yeah, thanks for your time today.
Yeah, thank you for coming out. We had a good day. Hopefully, the kids didn't bother you guys too much.
No. Hey, we understand. As a fellow parent, I get it. I understand, yeah. And we're glad that John and Lily, and we had Ali and your wife here, was corralling them as much as we could. So I think everyone will like the finished product in our Father's Day catalog for 2020.
Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.